Hey guys, welcome back to another exciting tutorial of creatnprocess, and today we're working on this logo design and we'll be discussing each and every steps required to create this design. So if you look at this logo, the design is derived from the basic shape circle. The flow of the design is also following the circular shape along with this semicircular details. And if you look at this wings, it has got a nice gradient color and it has been created using the pen tool. So to create this logo, we'll first understand that the most important tool which we have used in the creation of this logo is the ellipse tool. So with the help of ellipse tool, we'll create out this basic shape. Then we'll duplicate it for multiple number of times and create out all these important details. Then after that, with the help of Shipbuilder tool, we'll create out separate out each pieces separately. Then we concentrate on creating these wings, and to create these wings we'll use the pen tool and the direct selection tool to create out the overall design. Then with the help of Shapebuilder tool, we'll separate out each piece, and finally we'll add up the gradient color from this color palette. So let's begin with the tutorial. So select the ellipse tool and left click your mouse button. Here I put the width around 170 and height around 220 for this logo design. That's why I've created that. And after that, I'll fill up the stroke color like that, and I'll just place it around here. Now I'll just tilt this with the shift press to 45 degree like that. Next, what I'll do is I'll duplicate this, Control C, Control F, and I'll just scale this down a little bit like that, giving that nice thickness. And I'll just push this a little bit this side with the arrow key, giving that nice this side, pushing that. Now after that, what I'll do is I'll just do a few more duplications. So I'll just select this, Control C, Control F, duplicated it. I'll just scale it down like from the side, giving that like that. And this one, I'll just scale it from here. This one, inner circle, I'm creating that. So this going that flow and like that, okay. Now I'll just duplicate this one more, Control C, Control F, and this one, what I'll do is I'll just scale it down very small like this, and around here like that, and I'll just extend this till this much. Maintaining the proportion is important, like that. So let's keep it like that. Now what I'll do is I'll duplicate it, Control C. Before that, let me check here. Okay, this flow, it's good like that. So duplicate this, Control C, Control F, and scale it up like that. Now Control C, Control F, scale it up, and let's push it, keep it around here. From here, I'll just bring this inside, and this one, stand this still this much. So this one is the inner one. So I'm just doing that. One, I can just make it a little bit smaller like that, and this one a little bit like that. So it's all about adjustment of the circles, and this one we have to maintain it. So I'll just make it a little bit smaller from here, giving that here. Let's tilt this a little bit, like giving some flow to here like that. So after that, I'll just duplicate this one more, Control C, Control F, and I'll just scale it down like this, giving this inner detail. And this one we need to do little adjustments, so let's play around with this, like giving that nice thickness to that. And this one we can just make it smaller, maintaining that flow. So overall we have to maintain here, select the rings, just go around and make sure they are in the same order like that. So overall, if you look it out, it's done. So nice, we have created 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 rings. And that's all. Now select everything, and with the Shapebuilder tool, what I'll do is I select a certain color from here first of all, and I'll just click one click here. So we have given this nice one. Now I'll just choose different color from here like this, and this one give a different color. I choose a different color here and place it around here. I'll choose some more color here, choose click different color, click. Now let's check it out. If we concentrate here, it's good, it's maintaining the flow like that. Here I think, yeah, it's also good. So overall it's good. Now select these unwanted pieces like that. First of all, let's delete this out from here, selecting, deleting that, we don't need that. From here I'll just select this, okay, that's good. So selecting this piece, these, and I'll just move this little bit aside. and I'll just delete these all these unwanted pieces here. Let me check here this one. What is this? Okay, we don't need this. Delete this out. Okay, you can see that. Now this one, let me check. This one is unwanted here. So overall, we got all these. I'll select everything and remove this stroke color. Now we got this. Now just select this and let's fill it up with certain color for a while. So I just select it and fill it up with a different color from here. Or maybe I just directly select it from here. So with eye picker, I select this color and just place it there. This one with the eye picker, I select this color. This one with the eye picker, I select this color, this one, and select this. With the eye picker, I select this one, select the object with the eye picker, with the shift and alt pressed, select this color. So we got these colors, and if you want to do adjustments, you can just go around and do the adjustments here. So we need a little bit of adjustments here, so G, and just go around and do these adjustments and you'll get that. So we'll do that later on. First of all, now here we can see there's a gap, so we need to cover it up. So with the die selection tool, select this tool and let's bring this and attach it till here, so that we can just make sure that they are maintaining the flow like that. So here, bring this one and bring it till here like that. And this one, I will just push it down a little bit, maintaining that curve. Let's push it like that. This one, let's keep it in touch. This one, maintain the handle. And this one, we can just play around with the handles and make sure they are with the flow. So selecting this point, we'll bring this here and this one and place it around here. And let's maintain the curve. So with the handle tool, selecting that, just maintain this flow like that, covering that up. In the same way, select this, this one, and let's bring this to here. So only the point should be selected, so this point, and just bring it like here. And let's maintain the flow. So just use the handles and just maintain that flow here. We have got some gaps, so just bring it down. Here we got a little gap here, so we'll use the handles and just make sure it's filled up. Maybe we'll just make it bigger like that, and let's see. Okay, that's fine. So we have almost covered it up. Now next thing we need to do is we need to create this wings. So to create the wings, we use the pen tool. So select the pen tool. I just draw out a wing from here and going till here and giving a nice curve. So I'll just make sure to align with that and this curve like that. Break the point and here, fill this up till here like that, giving that nice curve. And after that, break it and just maintain the flow according to the design like that. Now after this, let's fill this up with some plain color for a while, like blue, and let's remove the stroke color and make it like go to transparency mode and make it multiply. Now what I'll do is I'll just duplicate this, Control C, Control F, and with the die selection tool just click this point and just drag it up like that. And we'll do the adjustments. So with the handle selected, just do the adjustments. This one, just go around and do the adjustments. Now again, select that, Control C, Control F, duplicate it with the die selection tool selected. Again, click this point and bring it till here. And with the handle tool, just play around with the handle. This one, maintain the curve like that. And again, duplicate this, Control C, Control F, with the die selection tool selected, select the point, bring it up. This one is fourth one, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4th. So let's make it thick like that. This one, maintain the curve like that. And again, one more last time, duplicate this, Control C, Control F, and with the die selection tool selected, select this point and bring it till here. So it's all in your opinion, how many wings or how many rings you want here. So I need 5, so I'm just playing around and I just do some placement properly here, giving that thickness, and done. So overall done. I select all these, I'll just fill this up with some dark color and go to transparency and make it like overlay, you can see it. Or maybe let's check it out darker. If you change the transparency mode here, it's normal, so let's bring it out here for a while. And so select everything, and what we'll do is we go to here and let's choose this dark color one, dark blue, and you can see nice gradient color has been formed. And you can directly apply this to your logo, but if you want to do some further thing, you have to select everything, and let's do that with the help of Shapebuilder tool. I'll just break this down, so select make this one, this one, and okay, that's fine. Now what I'll do is I'll just separate these, all these pieces separate out like this and this, all these. Before that, let's change the color. So I just choose some different color from here so that I can differentiate that, and just click on that, and these pieces are also going to be separate. Now these are separate pieces, these are separate pieces. Now let's fill this up with the color. So what I'll do is I select all these pointed shapes, and with the eye picker select this color blue. Now select these inner pointed shapes, and with the eye picker select this little dark blue. And last one, select this, and with the eye picker select this dark. Now I'll just select everything and group this up. So selecting that, Control G, and now if I place it here, you can see that our wing is now formed. You can easily rotate it like in your own way. So let's do the rotation here like this or this maybe, and place it in the proper place. And I'll just adjust the gradient color G and just move around with this from lighter to darker, so that you can see, we can get that nice feel here, like it has been merged like that. And I'll just duplicate this one more, and what I'll do is I'll go to here, reflect tool, double click on that, and I'll just make it vertical and okay. So after that, just rotate this to a certain angle like this and arrange it to back, and after that just place it along this like that. And I'll just scale this down a little bit, so it's, because it's on the back side, so the wings is going to be a little bit smaller like that. And if we check it out, we have got already got that design. And next we need to add that eye, so let's add that eye with the ellipse tool. Select the white color and I'll just place it around here. Okay, that's good. So, and let's scale this down a little bit like that, and let's play around with the gradient color. So here we need to play with the gradient color, your lighter to darker like that. It's good, it's already there. We need to duplicate this, or maybe we need a half division here, so I'll just create one more like that, and keep it 170 by 220, the earlier one like that. And I'll just do is rotate this to 45 degree angle like that, and again place it over there along that. And after that I'll just scale this down a little bit to its half, and selecting both with the shape builder tool, just separate this piece out. Let's fill this up with certain color so that you can see that like that. And rest, I'll just delete this out, separate thing which is not necessary. So let's check it out. Okay, it's fine. And let's fill this up with this color. So with the eye picker I select this, and with the gradient tool I just play around with the gradient color, so from lighter to darker like that. So let's check it out, from lighter to darker in this way. So just play around, and let's check it out. So it's fine, it's looking good. Let's bring this up to the front, and let's check it out if we have left a few more details. Here. Okay, here we need to play around with the gradient tools. I'll just make it a little more brighter like that. Okay, that's good. G, bring it back. getting out with the gradient color, and let's check it out. This one need to give some dark color, so give that dark color, and let's bring it nearer to that so that we can lighter plus darker together. G, make it lighter. So we got that nice effect here, and let's finalize with the text. So I'll just type out the text escape, and the font which I'm using here is Candera, and I'll just select the Candera font from here. So select that out, and the color which I'm using is dark blue here, so same, and just play around with the font size, and let's play around with the gapping between the alphabets. Let's increase it a little bit, and let's place it here properly like that. Let's decrease the font size a little bit here like that, and let's do some adjustments here. We need to turn the angles like a little bit up, and we can make it a little bit smaller wings like that, you can see. And this one we can just reduce the size here so that it's fitting, and let's play around with the arrows, making it a proper flow, giving that. And finally we have created this design, and we have followed all the steps which is required. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.